Good afternoon, everyone, and I welcome you all to An Academy. So here we have with us Ritika Sachan. She is one of my friend, and we have done the BTech from the same college. And she has joined NITI Mumbai. She joined NITI Mumbai in 2017 with the GATE score 723. And आज मैंने इनको invite किया है so that हम सारी information जो NITI Mumbai की है वो जान सके and as well as whatever score that you may be getting on GATE examination. So if you're falling in this score, आपको अगर NITI Mumbai से call आ रहा है, then how you can prepare for your interview, as well as जो भी written GD NITI Mumbai में होता है, वो सारी बातें आज रितिका हमारे साथ शेयर करेंगी. As well as जैसा कि सभी को पता है, NITI Mumbai में 100% placement होता है. That is why this is something जो बहुत attract करती है students को, वो form apply करने के लिए. So कितने rank तक या कितने score तक students apply कर सकते हैं, उसके बाद किस तरीके से चीजों को handle करना है, वो सारी बातें रितिका हमें बताएंगी. So रितिका, on to you, please.
Thank you Minu, thank you for calling me. So basically I'll start from the GATE examination. So once you are done with your GATE examination, you have to fill a form for NITI Mumbai, and they provide courses. So through GATE, when I joined, they had three courses, industrial engineering, project management, and manufacturing management. But as per the latest information, I guess manufacturing management they have removed. So now they have two courses, but they have increased the number of seats. So you have to fill separate forms for separate courses. So suppose you are filling one form for IE, and then you have to fill another form for PM. And then coming up to the score. So score varies year by year because there are various factors, and it all depends on the number of applications they are giving and what kind of GATE examination. That depends on the toughness of the examination. So there is no set score that they like keep as a baseline criteria. It will all depend on various factors, but I'll say if you are in general category and you have a score of around 750, that's a good score. There is high chances that you'll get a shortlist. Okay. And then if I talk about the process, so basically you will get a call, interview call, and in interview they conduct GD. There is no written examination. So one is GD and then second is interview. So basically you will get the call for interview and then you have to go. But there are set criteria. So your GATE score, it will have some weightage. So once you will get the call, and interview has a weightage of around 30%. So you have a like high chance that if you will do a good interview, you can convert your call. Okay. And then there is some weightage to your BTech 10-12 marks. And if you have some work experience beforehand, so it also has some weightage. So based on all these criteria, they prepare their own merit list and they consider GATE score also, but it doesn't have like not much weight, as you can say around 45% around weightage is given to the GATE score. So based on all these criteria, they prepare their own merit list.
ओके सो रितिका, ओवर एंड ऑल रिटन पेपर नहीं होता है, सिर्फ इंटरव्यू में जीडी होता है एंड देन इंटरव्यू होता है, एंड गेट का स्कोर इज ओनली 45%. सो जो लोगों ने 10th और 12th में मार्क्स बहुत ज्यादा लेकर के आए हैं, उन लोगों के लिए बहुत अच्छी बात है ये. सो रितिका, नाउ कमिंग ऑन टू द लैंग्वेज, इंग्लिश लैंग्वेज इज मस्ट, क्योंकि ये बहुत बड़ा मिथ है कि हाँ भाई इंग्लिश लैंग्वेज चाहिए. ये मिथ है या सच्चाई है ये आप बताएंगे. इंग्लिश लैंग्वेज मस्ट है?
Yeah, it is must. Basically, so after joining NITI, you are preparing for managerial positions and you are going to be in MNCs. So you are dealing with, you know, people of multi-language people. So English becomes a criteria, obviously, but it's not just like any other job. You don't need to have a very, you know, high-fi accent or very proper English, because NITI provides, in 2 years, it provides you a good platform to work on your language, work on your personality. You have like pretty basic English skills also. You have enough time, 2 years of time to work on your language and improve it. So I'll say, obviously, you should know English. That is must. But you always have, you know, chance to improve it. You can work on it. English, like language, is never a barrier. You can work on it. You can learn it, and you can improve. So you, you think that you are not, but certainly I'll say that communication skills play a vital role when you are going for a managerial position. So you have to, either you have already good communication skills or you should be ready to work on them.
Yeah. Okay, Ritika. So GD के लिए कैसा वहाँ पर arrangement होता है, कितने लोग देते हैं और topics कैसे देते हैं और किस तरीके से उसको manage करेंगे, please?
Okay, so coming to the GD part, basically normally they form groups of 10 to 12 people and 12 minute ka GD hota hai. Topic wise, latest topic and there will be like all the general awareness topic, latest whatever is going on, latest happenings around the world in India, and generic topic also they can give you. So any abstract topic is also given. So there is no set pattern here. Topics will depend. So when you are going for GD preparation, I'll give you some tips basically. So you'll get 12 minutes of a GD round, and what you have to do that make sure that when you are going for GD round, you are making at least three entries. Don't speak anything just because you have to speak. If you have a valid point, solid point, go forward, put it forward, and try to initiate the discussion. And if possible, if you are not able to initiate the discussion, you can try and conclude the discussion. So these are some places where you can, you know, gain some brownie points, highlight yourself during the discussion. But you have to make sure that you are following proper GD etiquettes. And when also they'll send you call, they'll send you email, they also mention some GD etiquettes. So you have to go through those, you know, points and remember them while doing the discussion.
Okay, Ritika. And then once you, if you are selected in GD round, then you also have to go for the interview round. So what kind of interview do they take? It is technical or HR type?
So one good thing is that GD round is not elimination round.
Okay.
Everybody,
it's not an elimination round.
Get some, yeah, it's not an elimination round. You'll get to go for interview. And then you go for interview. So if you are a fresher, mostly they'll focus on your projects. And whatever your courses were during your graduation, during your BTech, whatever the your branch, like if you're from mechanical, they'll focus on mechanical subjects like that. And if you are a work experience, if you have some work experience, they'll talk around your work experience, the kind of projects you have done. And then maybe some questions from your BTech branch.
और जो गेट को देने के लिए हम लोग सारा पढ़ते हैं मैकेनिकल इंजीनियरिंग, इफ आई टॉक अबाउट स्पेसिफिकली, तो जो सब्जेक्ट रिलेटेड क्वेश्चंस होते हैं वो ज्यादा होते हैं या मतलब सिर्फ आपका प्रोजेक्ट रिलेटेड या ये सब?
दैट विल डिपेंड ऑन द पैनल्स व्हाटएवर विल यू नो दे'ल So the best thing about the interview is like it mostly depends on the candidate, how you are driving your interview. So you have that choice. So if they'll ask you about the subjects and you'll focus more on your graduation, they'll start asking from graduation. But if you have given them another point, suppose you have done something, you have conducted some big event during your college, you have, you know, and you give them that point, they'll start discussion from there onwards. So interview is always driven by the candidate.
Okay. So Ritika, your life for 2 years in Native Mumbai, थोड़ा बताएं अपनी लाइफ के बारे में, कैसा रहा वहाँ का एनवायरनमेंट, उसके बाद हम प्लेसमेंट सेशन के बारे में बात करेंगे, बट व्हाट अ स्टूडेंट कैन एटलीस्ट थिंक कि हाँ मैं नेटिव मुंबई जाऊंगा, देन व्हाट थिंग्स आई एम गेटिंग गोइंग टू बी एक्सपोज्ड एंड व्हाट ऑल द थिंग्स दैट आई एम गोइंग टू गेट ओवर देयर.
So it was a pretty happening life, I'll say. You are in Mumbai and Niti has a very pretty campus. Like you'll feel like you are living in a resort for 2 years in Mumbai. So yeah. And then we have many committees, forums. So you can be part of those committees. They conduct various events. Like if you say in terms of opportunity, you have plenty of opportunities to learn, to prove yourself, and to do a lot of things. There are many events, and then on regular basis there are various companies who come there for case studies. So you'll have like so much to choose from. You can focus on case studies, then you have assignments, you can do projects. You are in Mumbai and there are many industries, so you can go out, talk to people, and then they have so much focus on entrepreneurship also. So there is a entrepreneurship cell that helps you in, you know, in inculcating those entrepreneurship skills. So if you have some orientation towards business, you can focus there. You'll have plenty of time to work on your business idea. So it's 2 years of happening life, a lot of exposure, I'll say, in terms of personality. You are, and because it's like people are coming from all over the different cultures in India. So you'll get to interact with too many people, learn about their culture. So from that aspect also, it provides you a good exposure.
Okay, Ritika, coming to the fees structure of NITI Mumbai, and do you get any stipend or something? Kuch stipend wagera milti hai wahan pe admission mein? So financial ka kaisa rehta hai in comparison to the stipend that you get and the fees that you have to pay?
So stipend is basically whatever was decided by MHRD. So at my time, we were getting around 12,500 per month. Mm-hmm. But that will highly depend on, so it's not free. Nothing comes free. So you have to do a TA, like teaching assistantship program. So you'll have a mentor, any professor, and then they'll give you some work and you have to do that work. So it will depend on their approval. If they'll approve, then you'll get that stipend. So, but you'll get that stipend. Yeah. And then coming to the, yes. So there is opportunity. You have to harness it. And then the fee structure during my time, I don't get into much details. Like I just tell overall, because you can get the fee structure and everything. They'll provide in form, so you'll get all the details in the internet. Basically, during my time, it was around 8 lakhs, and now they have increased the fees. As per my knowledge, it is 12 lakhs around. You can do the cross check, use the internet, do your search.
Okay, so 10-12 lakh ka kharcha,
and you'll get, so finances is not a constraint, I'll say, because NITI Mumbai has a very good placement record. So you'll get very easily, you will get loan, education loan. So I financed my education through education loan. So it's a very easy procedure. So if you feel that you are short on funds, don't, you know, make it a roadblock. You can just go ahead, have education loan, and then you can pay it back.
Okay, Ritika. So now coming to the placements that NITI Mumbai is offering, because this is one of the most important thing that we can talk about. And वो सभी को पता है कि placement बहुत अच्छा है NITI Mumbai का. But how student can be see themselves at the time of taking admissions, and also your experience of placement. कि कैसा रहा experience और आपके पूरा batch ही place था, जैसे कि आपने पहले भी मुझे बताया कि सारे सभी का हो गया, वहाँ पे कोई बचा नहीं. So giving that high amount of fees is also a good thing. कि चलो हाँ ठीक है, placement तो हो रहा है. So Ritika, आपका statement जो placement में रहा, experience जो placement में रहा.
So placement you will get opportunities. Number of companies that come to the campus is very high. You will get enough opportunities to sit for the placement. All you have to do is convert it. That's up to you. And so as you told that in my batch, it was 100% placement. Not a single person was left. So yeah, that is the thing. And if I talk about the package, so you will get average package during my batch, it was around 17 lakhs. Like I'm not very, you know, don't go to the dot numbers. I'm giving just an average that is in my mind exactly. You can do the cross check. NITI releases their placement report every year, so you can do and go through the report. Last year, I guess it was around 19-20 lakhs average package. Mm-hmm. So yeah, you can expect a good package. All you have to do is work on your personality, work on your skills, learn things, and prove yourself.
Okay. One thing more I want to ask Ritika is that आपके बैच में अगर आप रिकॉल कर पा रहे हो कि मिनिमम स्कोर जो स्टूडेंट का रहा हो, जिनका हुआ है सिलेक्शन, तो उसके बारे में, बिकॉज अभी यहाँ पर दिस इंटरव्यू इज मोस्टली मेनली बेस्ड अबाउट हाउ स्टूडेंट कैन डील विद द इंटरव्यू सेशन और द GD सेशन, दैट कितना मिनिमम में. ऐसा होता है ना कि जब आप पीछे के रैंक से सिलेक्ट होते हो तो लगता है कि शायद इंटरव्यू में नहीं होगा या GD में नहीं होगा, ये सबके दिमाग में रहता है. एंड समटाइम्स स्टूडेंट्स जो है वो अपना भूल जाते हैं, उन्हें लगता है कि शायद दे मे नॉट गेट सिलेक्टेड बिकॉज जस्ट विद द मार्जिनल मार्क्स दे हैव गॉटन टू द इंटरव्यू लिस्ट और द GD लिस्ट. सो व्हाट डू यू थिंक, इफ अ स्टूडेंट इज गेटिंग विद जस्ट अ मार्जिनल मार्क्स, कैन ही बी सिलेक्टेड इन द इंटरव्यू और GD?
Yeah, sure. I'll say that if you are even at the borderline and you have got the call, shortlist, there is a very high chance that you can convert. As I told earlier also, that 30% weightage is going to interview, and then some weightage is given for your 10-12 marks. So everything is not based on your GATE score. So if you have got the call, please go ahead. Please go for the interview. Go for the GD. There are high chances that you might convert it.
Okay. Next thing, Ritika, that I want to discuss over here or ask from you is that, do they prefer only the fresher? Because I have seen many people, students asking from me, are they even giving preference to 1 year, 2 year or 3 year droppers, or they only prefer the fresher people that just now you have done your BTEC and you have got some rank in GATE and then just come to UT. What is their preference?
Okay. So normally, like during the NEET interview, you won't face any difficulty. So if you have 2 year drop and you are able to justify it, so in interview, they may raise this question that why you have a 2 year. So I myself had a 1 year drop. So okay. I was preparing, and then, so it was not a difficult thing. So they'll just ask you during the interview, and if you are able to justify it, it won't be a problem. Work experience. If you have around 2 year work experience, it's ideal. Normally, for if you are going for managerial jobs, MBA, so they prefer that if you have around 2 year experience, that is ideal. But if you are fresher and you are giving good interview, so there is no such condition. Fresher, work experience, job, nothing should stop you from going and giving the interview.
Okay.
So don't keep any set pattern in your mind. Just go give the interview, give it a 100%, give you 100%, and then see what happens.
Okay.
Just one thing is that if some people have big 4 year of drop and everything. So in that case, sometimes getting shortlist from companies becomes a bit of a difficulty.
Yeah. At the time of placement, it becomes problematic.
Placement and summers for summer placement.
Okay, Ritika.
That's a task. Like you won't get as many shortlists as a person having 2 year drop or a fresher is getting, but you'll get shortlist. Just the number will be less.
So, Ritika, do you have any friend who had this kind of gap, 4 year gap, 3 year gap? And getting placed?
There was one person who had 3 year gap, but he also got placed.
Okay, he also got placed. So I think if you're going to NIT, then nobody can 2 year gap or 3 year gap is not going to be. Yeah, it may hinder sometimes, but it may not stop you from getting. So Ritika, what can be the best answer according to you that if I have a 1 year gap, so what do you think? Because you are 4 years, 4 to 5 years are over. So you may tell me with your experience and also with for all other students, what can be the best answer to this question that what did you do in 1 year or 2 year of gap at the time of interview? Because this is going to help a lot of students today.
Yeah, so you can just justify it by saying that after my college, I didn't have very good opportunities in my hand, and I know that I can do better. So I took a year drop and I focused on my preparation. And I think that drop year is also somewhere responsible that today I'm sitting here and I had this opportunity to appear for the interview. So you can justify it that I wanted more in life and I took a chance.
Okay, so that was really good answer. Okay, Ritika, so this was really nice meeting you today, and you have gave a lot of thing for all the students who are watching this session. And in the end, if you want to say something to all the students who are going to appear to the interview session of NIT, they probably may be watching you right now. They will watch this session. And if anything that you want to say to all of them who are appearing in the interview, this 2021 year.
Whenever you are going for anything, if you're appearing on anything, I'll just say that go prepared. Do your research, do your preparation. So suppose you're going for interview, so you should make your profile like I'm from this place. Read a bit about the place. You have done 10-12 and something about your interest, hobbies. So just go through them. If you have some hobby, if you like to dance, know about some dance forms, know about some dance personalities who are famous in this field. do your research, if you have done some project and you are mentioning it, so they send a form also where you know they ask you before the interview, they ask you about all these details, your hobbies, if you have done something, your achievements, something like that. So whatever you are mentioning there, make sure that you are going through it. You are, preparing questions. Prepare some HR questions also, like why MBA? Why you want to do MBA? What kind of, job you want? Why NITI? Why not any other MBA college? Something like that. Why not IIT? Why not M.Tech? Something like that. So all these questions. Do your search about NITI also, a bit research. About GD, so just be aware about the latest happenings, whatever is happening there. And if possible, if you have a group of friends, make sure that at least, you are practicing it. At least 2-3 sessions you are conducting in your group and you are practicing that you are able to speak. Because in GD, 12 people are speaking and there is just 12 minutes. Everybody has to put their points. So sometimes it becomes difficult to put your point. So if you have already done some practice, it will be very helpful.
Mm-hmm. Okay, thank you so much, Ritika. It was really nice talking to you, and I hope that this session is going to help a lot of students who are going to appear for the GD and the interview session for this year. And one more thing, Ritika, this is a little bit personal question that I'm going to ask in this platform. What was the strength of girls and boys in NITI Mumbai? I want to ask this. Okay. In your batch, how many girls were there?
Okay, I don't remember the exact numbers, but 60 around. The entire batch was, we were 60 girls and the batch strength was around 400. I'm not sure about the numbers. I'm
60 girls and 400 students batch. That means they are entering 800 students per year. So it's a big chance to get into NITI. It's not a small chance. 400 students in one, so it is a good amount. And 60 girls.
So, when I say 400 batch, it is entire, like all the 5 courses, around 400 seats are there.
Okay.
So 120 was in IE. In my batch, it was around 120, and we were around. I'm not remembering the exact numbers, but yeah, ratio is same as all the engineering colleges, you can say.
Yeah, 60 out of 60 in 400. So it's a good amount, it's not a problem, but girls should move on.
But it's not fixed.
It's not fixed, of course.
Because it's fixed. Junior batch, there were like more girls than our batch.
Of course, it is not fixed, but there is a range, then people feel more motivated. Okay, they are they try to find the difference.
Like any other engineering college, you can't expect like something.
No, but I think that being in KNIT Sultanpur, we were 60 batch and around like 10 to 12 girls were there in that BTech college. So, but in IITs, it is not the same scenario. In IITs, if you go, you will get 2 or 3 girls in the same batch. So it. If it in NITI Mumbai, if these many girls are there, so in that case, the environment is going to be a little bit more impressive. So, okay, Ritika, it was really nice talking to you, and everything went very smooth. And students are going to learn a lot from this session. And thank you, Ritika, for this.
Just one point, last point.
Sure.
Basically, most people will question this, that, the fees is very high. Is it worth? So one thing is so if you we are from KNIT Sultanpur, and Sultanpur is not a very happening place. It's very rural kind of
rural area.
The college is placed in a rural setup. So Mumbai gives you a lot of opportunity, exposure. So in terms of personality improvement and in terms of perspective improvement, NITI Mumbai provides a really good opportunity. So if you're questioning the worth in terms of finances and fees, I'll say it's worth it.
It's worth it. Okay, that was really, it's worth it. Means 10 to 12 lakh fees is worth it. After taking experience, I think most of the students are leaving apart from IITs and NITs. There are a lot of private colleges who students come and prepare for GATE and ESE, and they go to different IITs and ISEs and NITI Mumbai also. So that they face a lot of things. And for all of perspective, if you are going through this, this is a really nice opportunity and really nice thing to try out and then learn a lot and become a refined version of your own self. So again, thank you so much, Ritika. And
NITI Mumbai is a unique college actually that provides you.
Yeah, that's provide a lot of things over there.
Yeah, so I was saying that NITI Mumbai. Now, NITI Mumbai is a unique college that provides you opportunity to, you know, get entry through your GATE score and get into managerial position.
Managerial position.
So
this is
that
also
is not
good.
There in any other college.
This is also a good thing that technical, say you're going to some non-technical like type of thing, managerial job you're going. But if we see very clearly now, so if the recruitment in PSUs also, if it is through GATE, that is also for managerial job only. It is not for any technical job. You're not going to do the same like a vernier caliper of or any mechanical job. They are managerial jobs only. So NITI Mumbai is also one of them. Only M.Tech is something technical that you're getting from GATE score or GATE marks. Okay, Ritika. Again, I'm repeating. It was really nice talking to you. And KNIT Sultanpur ki thodi yaadein bhi aa gayi yahan par mere saamne. So it's really nice that we have people from KNIT Sultanpur also, from lot of places, and they are doing really nice in the respective field. So okay, thank you so much, Ritika, and thank you so much.
Thank you. It was my pleasure.